Hello everyone, we are studying the asymmetric synthesis course of the MSc second year organic chemistry. In this lecture, now we are going to start our next asymmetric reaction. In the last lecture, we have studied the asymmetric hydrogenation by using BiNAP as the chiral ligands and ruthenium catalyst. So corresponding chiral complex of the ruthenium metal that will carry out the asymmetric hydrogenation, and hydrogens are delivered on the particular one face of the double bond. So syn hydrogenation, we are getting the high amount of the enantiomeric excess. Now next, second reaction we are going to study, it is asymmetric epoxidation reaction, and it is also called as the Sharpless epoxidation reaction. It is very important reaction as point of competitive exam point of view. This reaction, it is useful for only allylic alcohols. So allylic alcohols containing the double bond, allylic double bond, that reactive double bond can shows the enantioselective reaction in the presence of the tertiary butoxyhydroperoxide compound and diethyl tartarate in presence of the titanium tetraisopropoxide compound. Now let us see first this reaction, general reaction. So this is asymmetric epoxidation. So double bond is accessible here for only the allylic alcohol compounds, can only shows this type of the asymmetric epoxidation. Now in this reaction, allylic alcohol is the substrate given here. Now the number of the reagents are included in the reaction that are used. In this case, it is the titanium tetraisopropoxide compound. This is titanium tetraisopropoxide. So it is transition metal catalyzed reaction. Titanium, it is the transition metal complex, titanium isopropoxide, and this complex catalyzes the reaction. So it acts as the catalyst in the reaction. This is first reagent. Secondly, L plus or D minus diethyl tartarate is used. The structure of the diethyl tartarate, it is this is the structure of DL plus, this is L plus diethyl tartarate, or second is the D minus diethyl tartarate. In that molecules only these OH groups are orienting downward direction or alpha oriented. So L plus diethyl tartarate molecule act as the chiral ligand in this reaction. These are act as the ligands. So this is the structure of the L plus diethyl tartarate, that means OH group which are present, these are beta oriented in the L plus DT, and in D minus DT these OH groups are alpha oriented. So we can write like this. So this is the D minus diethyl tartarate molecule. Now next reagent used, it is the tertiary butoxy hydroperoxide compound. This act as the oxidizing agent in this reaction, and this oxidizes the double bond, allylic double bond, and deliver the oxygen to the double bond, and the corresponding epoxide is formed. Now this reaction is highly enantioselective, highly asymmetric. It gives nearly 85% of the yield of the product, and enantiomeric excess is 94%. So we can observe this in this reaction that when L plus DAT, this type of ligands are used, L plus diethyl tartarate, we are getting the alpha oriented epoxide is obtained here, because the oxygen is delivered from the bottom side. When we use the D minus diethyl tartarate, if we use this molecule in the reaction, in the oxidation reaction, then we are getting the corresponding बीटा ओरिएंटेड इपॉक्साइड इज फॉर्म. दिस टाइप ऑफ इपॉक्साइड इज फॉर्म व्हेन वी यूज्ड द डी माइनस डाइथिल टार्टरेट एज द लिगेंड. सो रिएक्शन स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री कैन बी चेंज्ड बाय चेंजिंग द कायरल लिगेंड. So these are the two enantiomer of the chiral ligand. If we use one enantiomer, we are getting one type of the enantiomeric product. If we use the another enantiomer for the chiral ligand, we are getting the another enantiomer of the epoxide compound. Now in this case, this reaction, it is carried out in presence of the titanium complex, titanium isopropoxide complex. This react with this ligand, it will form the further complex, get complex with the diethyl tartarate molecule, and further it get reacted with the oxidizing agent tertiary butoxyhydroperoxide, and then it will get bind to the olefins and oxygen is delivered and the oxidation reaction is can be carried out. Now if you consider this allylic alcohol, so this reaction, it is possible or given for only allylic alcohol. So if OH group is not present, only double bond is there or conjugated double bond is there, so epoxidation, it is not possible. So basic criteria for the substrate, it is the allylic alcohol should be present. Now this allylic alcohol, we have shown here the stereochemistry, how the reaction works. The diethyl tartarate meant D minus diethyl tartarate, this chiral ligand is used or enantiomer is used, then it delivers the oxygen on the top face of this double bond. It will delivers on the top face. So we are getting the beta oriented epoxide in this case. So we are getting this type of epoxide. When we use the L plus DT, this chiral ligands, it delivers the oxygen from the bottom side. It delivers the oxygen from the bottom side of this double bond. So it delivers the oxygen from the below face or bottom side of the double bond. So we are getting the alpha oriented epoxide. So we will get this type of the alpha oriented epoxide is formed. So if we change the chiral ligand, accordingly product of the reaction will be changed. Now let us see the what will be the mechanism for this reaction, how reaction actually works for the oxidation conditions. So we have to consider for this titanium complex. First, it contains four isopropyl group. Firstly, it will get bonded to diethyl tartarate molecule. So further reaction between the titanium tetra isopropoxide complex act as the catalyst, and the diethyl tartarate will react to form the further complex molecule. Let us see the structure of this molecule. So we can see here structure, the titanium. Now two molecules of the titanium tetraisopropoxide, they will get reacted and this further complex is formed. So two titanium metal ions are present in this complex. Further, two isopropoxide molecules will get eliminated here and these are replaced by the another oxygen. Now in this complex, each titanium, it is bonded to two isopropoxide group. Here we can see this is first isopropoxide group, another second. Here is one isopropoxide group and another is the above the plane. So each titanium, it is now bonded to two isopropoxide group, and two isopropoxide group will get eliminated by the another oxygen. And this oxygen, these oxygen are coming from the corresponding diethyl tartarate molecule. Now let us see the structure, this CH2, this CH, CH. So these are coming from the diethyl tartarate molecule. So in the diethyl tartarate, two OH secondary OH groups are present. We know that these are the two secondary OH group, and the remaining part of the diethyl tartarate, that is 2COT, and here is COT. So this is one diethyl tartarate molecule. This molecule OH groups are bonded to the titanium. Now here the another diethyl tartarate molecule. This is another diethyl tartarate molecule. It is bonded to the titanium metal from the above side. So we can see here this COET, two OH group which are present above side of this titanium. These two OH group, they are coming from the another molecule of the diethyl tartarate. So the remaining part will be COET is shown here. And this COET, another the carbonyl group of this diethyl tartarate, it get bonded to titanium and get coordinated from the below side. So it will get stabilized, titanium will get stabilized. Again here, the one of the carbonyl group of the COET group, it is get bonded to the titanium from the below side. So these are the two diethyl tartarate molecules. So each titanium, it is bonded to two isopropoxide group and the one diethyl tartarate molecule at the oxygen atom. Now in this case, the oxygen atom, another oxygen atom here, which is present carbonyl group, which is bonded to the titanium. So this is the overall structure of the complex formed here. This double complex now, in the second step, it will react with the oxidizing agent used. It is tertiary butoxy hydroperoxide molecule. So this tertiary butoxy hydroperoxide, it will get bonded from the below side. It replaces one of the isopropyl group, and this oxygen which is coordinated to titanium, this bond undergo broken, and these two coordinating side, now these are occupied by the two oxygen of the tertiary butoxy peroxide molecule. So what we are getting, what is the difference in the structure only here? This one isopropyl group and the carbonyl group which is bonded to titanium, this bond undergo breakage, this one and this one. So these oxygens are replaced by the two oxygen of the tertiary butoxy hydroperoxide, and hydrogen is removed in order to satisfy the valency of the oxygen. Now this oxygen, it is found to be the reactive oxygen that will oxidize the double bond. So this is the first step of the complex. At first step, the titanium tetraisopropoxide, two molecules of the titanium tetraisopropoxide will get combined together and react, removal of the two isopropoxide molecule, and the two diethyl tartarate molecule will get complex with this molecule. So this is first step. In second step, what happens? The tertiary butoxy hydroperoxide molecule will get bonded to the titanium on the below side. Here we are getting this type of the structure. Now in the next step, the allylic alcohol is going to react with this complex at the top position here. So this isopropyl group can be easily removed, which is present on the top face of this titanium. So let us see the next step here. In this step, the alcohol, now allylic alcohol, it is going to react with this complex in such a way that the isopropyl group which is present on the top face, it will get removed, and this oxygen will get bonded to now titanium. So here oxygen, CH2 double bond, and the R group or the side chain present in the allylic alcohol. Now see this orientation of the double bond. Now this double bond, it is bonded or it is attached to the complex by the oxygen atom. And now orientation, we can see here, the orientation of this, this is the structure and this is the further diethyl molecule, it will remains as it is, toy COET, and this is also contains the toys, so this is CO2-ET. This diethyl tartarate structure remains as it is. Now this double bond is oriented in such a way that it is closer to this oxygen now, which is given from the tertiary butoxy hydroperoxide. This is tertiary butoxy part of tertiary butoxy hydroperoxide. This is the reactive oxygen present here. So this oxygen now slowly get coordinate or get react with this double bond. So slowly this oxygen will get delivered on this double bond. We are getting the corresponding structure. Now, from this structure, all the bonds which are bonded to titanium remains as it is in the complex. Only the change is this oxygen is get delivered on this double bond, and we are getting the corresponding structure here. This epoxide is formed, and this oxygen is present on the below side. Here is corresponding R group is present. So this is the corresponding complex. Now in this complex, the oxygen, it will get removed and isopropyl group will get substituted on this side, and we are getting the corresponding structure of the epoxide molecule. So this is the oxidation of the double bond, allylic double bond, in the asymmetric manner, and we are using the particular reagents, that is oxidizing agent is very important. It is used tertiary butoxy hydroperoxide, which shows the selectivity in the bonding to the transition metal, it is titanium. And it will gives the oxygen, provides the oxygen for epoxidation reaction, and we are getting the alpha oriented epoxide. So this asymmetric reaction, it is very useful reaction, and we can carry it out at the high yield, and high enantiomeric excess is obtained from this reaction. So it is called as the asymmetric epoxidation or sharpless epoxidation reaction. So similarly, in this reaction we have used the L plus DET molecule, L plus diethyl tartarate. So similarly, if we change this ligand, D minus diethyl tartarate, if we use, in that case the oxygen will get delivered on the top face of this double bond, top face of the double bond. In such a case, in this case, the oxygen which is bonded here, so here this oxygen will get delivered on the top face. So when D minus DET is used, in that case this tertiary butoxy hydroperoxide, it will get bonded from the above side, and oxygen will get delivered on the above side at this position. So we will get the corresponding beta oriented epoxy. So this is about the Sharpless epoxidation reaction. It is used to convert the allylic alcohol into corresponding epoxy. So this is all for the today's lecture. In the next lecture, we will see the examples of the asymmetric reactions and another asymmetric hydroxylation reaction. Thank you.